First set. Edberg to serve. Quiet, please. Ready? Play. First game. Zetsky to serve. Fertile. Fertile. Game Zetsky, one game all. First service. Game Edberg. Edberg leads by 2-1. First set. Love 15. Second service. Love 30. Love 40. First service. Thirty, 40. Deuce. Ladies and gentlemen, quiet please during play. Thank you. Advantage, Ruzetsky. First service. Deuce. Advantage, Ruzetsky. Yes. Advantage, Ruzetsky. Game, Ruzetsky. Two games on. Come on. 15 and up. First service. That's you. Edberg leads by 3-2. First set. Take your seats quickly, please. Seats quickly, thank you. That's enough. Kuzetsky.
3-1.15-love. Fetila. Forty fifteen. Game at Berg, new balls. Edberg leads by 4-3, first set. Fifteen. Thirty.
Portugal.
Game, Ruzetsky.
Four games all. Fifteen love. Thirty love. Game Edward. Edberg leads by 5-4, first set. Service. Love 15. Fifteen. 40-15.
40-15. Game, Rosetsky.
5 games all.
Thirty.
Game at.
Edberg leads by 6-5. First set.
Time.
Quiet, please. Thank you.
15 love.
Thirty, 15. 40, 15. Game. Rosetsky. Six games all. First set. Tiebreak. Edberg to serve.
And we're watching a cracking match here. I think the number two seed might be a bit surprised by this tall 19-year-old, ranked 155 in the world.
1-0, Edberg.
Greg Rusedski had to qualify for these championships, and he's putting up a terrific performance. Big, powerful serving left-hander. Gone with serve so far. And this typical of the way the Canadian has been playing. The return a little bit high, but really positive in the volley. Clearly not intimidated by the situation.
Rusedski.
Oh, that's great play. And Rusedski taking the initiative, despite the fact that Edberg was in behind the serve. It was a great return, and he comes in behind it to make that killing volley. And that's, I mean, that's really aggressive play from a youngster who actually failed to qualify for Wimbledon last year, played Junior Wimbledon in 1991. So Rusedski has two breaks of serve in this tie break. And the way he's been serving, Edberg has got his work cut out to get this back. Number two court, of course, renowned as the champion's graveyard. Well, not just the champions, but the favourites' graveyard. Serving 5-1 up.
Rusedski.
Important for him to get the first serve in. That's a good serve.
5-3, Rusedski.
Chance for Rusedski, steps inside the baseline. Nearly a terrific return from this young man, just catching the tape. But he still has one service break to his advantage in this first set tiebreaker. Rusedski has the problems when he misses his first serve. The second one was short, and that opened it up for Edberg. Really nice return. And despite his long reach, Rusedski not able to get it back. So they're back on level terms.
6-5, Rusedski.
It's really quite warm out on court, and he's having to towel down after practically every point. And if it goes on like this, then Edberg is going to know he's been in a contest. Set point.
6-0.
Stefan Edberg with this remarkable record. This is his 41st consecutive Grand Slam since he played at Wimbledon in 1983, and nobody else has ever achieved that. Very much at the other end of the scale, a man starting out on the road. 6-6, first set tiebreak.
Ruzetsky.
It's his fourth double fault, and he's really picking some unfortunate moments to serve them. Giving the young Canadian another chance to take the first set. That's a thundering first serve. Well, he felt he had to go for it, and really pressing on the second serve,
quiet,
just
please.
Too long.
Quiet, please. Thank you.
That's unlucky. Right idea, but just couldn't quite control the low volley. And so now Edberg gets his first set point.
Eight all.
Great work from the Canadian. Really didn't look as though he had a hope of getting that one back, let alone winning the point. Just goes to show what perseverance can do.
Thank you.
Wide.
9-8, Ruzetsky.
And wide by a distance, too. Bad miss from Edberg. And a third chance for Greg Ruzetsky to take the first set against the number two seed. Oh, dear.
9-all.
Well, maybe just striving a little too hard. Two double faults from each man in this tie break. And I think they're rather glad that they've got tickets for number two court. Nine all.
Ten, nine, Edberg.
Well, that is really very unfortunate for Ruzetsky. And Edberg
quite
gets
please.
His second chance at the set.
Game and first set, Edberg.
7-6. Time. Take your seats quickly, please. Seats quickly. Second set. Rosetsky to serve.
Well, Rosetsky just has lost his rhythm a little bit on serve, which cost him that first set tiebreak. He's got to find it again quickly. That ball was definitely going out, and he took a bit of a gamble in playing it. He almost smashed it out. This is a rather high return, and again, an easy kill, but he does it well. Hitting it very nice and short, giving Edberg no chance at all of getting the return. Well, the serve was too short, easily setting up the passing return from Edberg. Cursing himself, and well he might, because that serve that was so effective in the first set has seems to have deserted him completely.
Game Edberg. First game, second set. First set, Edberg.
Well, that's the last thing that the 19-year-old Canadian needed, having contested the first set excellently, then to go and lose his serve right at the beginning of the second set. Mark, I know you've only just, Mark Cox, only just come in to watch this, but your early impressions?
Well, of course, Rosetsky has had the benefit, I think, of playing all through the qualifying and at Beckenham too, and it's important to get matches in the bag, as it were, and Edberg has taken a while obviously to familiarize himself. Court 2 historically has been known as the graveyard. The better players psychologically somehow find it difficult to play out on this specific court. I don't know why, it's just that there's been a stream of results in the past where the top players have had difficulty, and that does play on the minds of the players. And Hedberg now looks, having had such a difficult time in that tiebreak, I think a very important part of the match, has now settled down just that little bit more, and he's going to be more decisive. And that was illustrated, of course, with the first break of serve in the match.
Did you have that problem on number two court?
No, well, if I won, that was the upset.
Quiet, please. Quiet, please. Thank you.
Hedberg then with the break.
Love 15.
The best thing, of course, that he can do is immediately break back.
Not an easy shot. This is a miss hit, so the bounce is going to be a little precarious. And his opponent, well, that was rather daredevilish, wasn't it?
Oh, that's a terrific shot.
Well, so often the controlled block shot with a little bit of slice into the angle is effective.
Standard of tennis, terrific. I mean, you're seeing man ranked 155 in the world against a man ranked 3 in the world. Oh, well played indeed.
Does well to get the serve back.
Game
from Rozetsky. The body, and it forces the ball at the feet of Hedberg.
Second
a little
set.
Bit of disguise with that forehand. So both players securing a break of serve.
And Rozetsky's return of serving is so impressive. If you can get the big first serve going as well, he'll certainly be in the match.
Love 15.
A little bit unlucky here, Rozetsky, because this return clips the top of the net and he just can't move quite quickly enough to pick up the reflex shot.
Love 13.
He's got the problem when he misses his first serve that he feels he's really got to push on the second, and it's causing a lot of double faults.
Second service. Love 40.
Very square, broad shoulders. He's listed in the book at 6'1". I must say he looks taller than that. Quite a lanky build. First set was so dominated by serve, 5 games to love.
Second set going against serve.
Game, Edberg. New balls, please. Edberg leads by 2 games to 1, second set, and by 1 set to love.
Well, despite the break there, Ruzedski is posing Edberg with all the traditional problems of the left-hander, Mark.
Yes, I agree with you that he looks much larger than the book indicates. And, of course, Edberg is 6'2", and he looks taller than Edberg. But the left-handed slice serve, if it goes in, of course, he served 2 double faults in the last game, and that's rather handing the point, obviously, to Edberg. But when it does go in, you can see the ball swing so much and poses problems for the return of serve. And I suspect in the first set, that's why there were so many love games, his serving was far more accurate. Now, it's reached a little bit of a tense stage, having lost the first set on the tiebreak. Now he's trying to assert himself and trying to do just a little bit too much with the serve. And at the same time, his opponent, Edberg, he too hasn't settled down, which is a bit surprising.
Time.
One would have felt that having secured that tentative first set, Edberg, he would have felt more comfortable and would grasp this match. As you quite rightly say, this man is ranked 155 in the world, but certainly not playing at that ranking level.
To your seats quickly, please.
But he is one of the up-and-coming young Canadian players
that
we're going to see a lot more of in the future, without question. So here's Edberg serving 2-1.
Definitely long, but it was a late call and not indicated by the magic eye. First 3 games of this set gone against serve. Hard to imagine that a fourth one will as well. Edberg, too, not shy on doubles. That's his 5th early in the second set. And he's missing that by a long way. I mean, that was best part of a foot below the net cord.
Fertil.
Giving his opponent every chance to make it four in a row against the serve. Vying with each other who can serve the most double faults in the match.
Well,
not a bad second serve, but with a great deal of relief, Hedberg manages to get that forehand volley away. Very tentative on his serve at the moment.
I know it's true of a lot of players, but I think it's particularly true of Hedberg that when his serve is not right, the rest of the game really tends to suffer as well. So important for him to have a good rhythm on the serve.
Advantage, Hedberg.
Oh, bit of a gift in the end from Hedberg.
And the makings of a really good rally here, but good defensive play by the Canadian. There, up goes the lob. Now he covers the smash. Now Hedberg really a little bit flat-footed here because his opponent way out of court. That was a relatively easy shot, and that indicates the stress and the strain which is on Edberg's shoulders at the moment. Well, this is an ill-fated game for Hedberg. Now, it's a very good forehand volley. Look how deep it is. And he's in position here. He's expecting to play a little drop volley, but the ball clipped the top of the net. Most unfortunate.
Advantage, Hedberg.
Game, Edberg. Edberg leads by 3-1, second set.
And at last he stops the rot with a good second service. Man who's won 6 Grand Slam titles, 2 United States, 2 Australian, and twice in Wimbledon. Looking for his third. A left.
15 love.
One of those that was just slightly mishit and had to make a quick decision whether it was just drifting out or not.
Well, this is the classic left-hander's point. Look how far out of court Edberg is, and that sets up for the easy backhand volley into the open space.
Oh, well done.
40 love.
Bit of good fortune here for Rzetsky. It was a really bit of a mishit and turned out to be more effective, I think, that shot than they anticipated.
That's a terrific
game
volley.
Rzetsky. Edberg
well,
leads
he covers
by
this
3 games to 2.
And look at the angle that he finds. He's a little bit off balance. But on a grass court, the stage in the tournament, we're just slightly soft. Those sort of short angle shots are very effective. There's a score. Stefan Edberg with a break in this second set. So this next game, I think, is going to be interesting to see, particularly how Edberg handles his serve. The last game on his serve, all of the signs of tension and lack of coordination that we have seen over the years from Stefan Edberg. He really needs to be very relaxed when he serves, and if he does so, then his serve is one of the great serves in the game, particularly for a grass court. He has lots of spin on the ball. It passes high over the net and bites into the court and leaps off the grass. But at the moment, his shoulders are tight, his arms are stiff, and his knees are rigid, and he's not flowing into the ball in the way that he would want.
Time.
So it's almost a perfect day for tennis. Spectators absolutely enjoying. It's not too hot there. Particularly out on this court number 2, they get a wonderful view, close to the players, and sense the atmosphere.
Quiet, please. Thank you.
3-2, Edberg serving.
That's another brilliant return.
15.
Anticipates this serve well. Look how he's inside the baseline there, the Canadian, and just hooks the ball back, a short backswing.
30-15.
Still, his serve troubles him. Seven double faults apiece now.
And this is a classic Edberg point, the slice serve, taking his opponent, putting him off balance, and then the backhand, his favourite shot, that volley.
Edberg.
Edberg leads by 4-2, second set.
And slowly just inching his way clear. When he gets his first serve in, it comes with a lot of weight. Just long. Well, nice idea. Rather than a repeat of the previous game where he put him wide and then sent the volley cross court, he tried to wrong foot him, which is a more difficult shot.
Game, Zetsky. Edberg leads by 4-3, second set, and by 1 set to love.
I think with the power of the modern game, they're going to have to issue line judges with protection before too long. But Mark, the confidence of youth here is interesting, isn't it? I mean, a lot of people say that experience is important, but you see it so often in top sport that people coming in their early stages haven't the experience of losing or feeling nervous, and they can be very aggressive.
Well, everything to go for, that's absolutely correct. And nothing to lose against one of the top players in the world, the number two seed. It's a wonderful opportunity for this young man who's had, as we've said, quite a bit of play on grass. Always when you come through the qualifying rounds at Wimbledon, which are played at the Bank of England, Roehampton, and the courts are extremely good there. Now, it's great practice, and a player comes in really match tight. And this young man is showing the value of the qualifying and those matches, those tough matches that he had during the qualifying. And he's come here uninhibited, without nerves, and giving of his best. He's claiming territory, whereas this man in the picture is defending all the time. It's always harder, I think, to defend the mountain than to climb it. And Edberg, as great a player as he is, in the early stages of a match, is in a tournament, is going to be just that little bit tentative, unsure about his own game, his confidence not quite there. And of course, this is the sort of match, in a way, he wants to gradually build his confidence, providing, obviously, he comes through it.
Quiet, please. Thank you.
So, 4-3 serving.
First serve.
This ideally is the game that Rozetsky wants to break back before Edberg gets within a game of the set. But he's up against it.
Well, in this rally, we see a superb backhand volley by Edberg right here. Difficult one off his toes. And look how deep it is. He covers the left-hand side of the court in our picture. And there is in complete control with that backhand volley.
That's the problem when you put the serve right onto the racket. He didn't have to move for it, right there on the forehand.
Well,
we've seen him play this slice angle return a number of times. So low over the net, so low, in fact, that it just clipped the top. I think Edberg thought it was going in the net. It's a good return, that one.
Edberg leads by 5-3, second set.
The net cord is totally impartial, working for both men. Rozetsky serving to stay in the second set. When that serve is going in, it's practically impossible for Edberg. He's got to hit an outright winner, really, to have any hope of winning the point, because he's so far out of court.
Four
Kotilov.
Change of tactic attempted by Edberg, looking for the sort of block and charge coming in behind the return. Well done.
Game. Grzetski.
Edberg leads by 5-4, second set, and by 1-0.
You were talking, Mark, about how Edberg would quite like this to get into the rhythm. How important is it, though, for a player coming into a 2-week major championship to be at the top of his form, near it, or how would he want to be?
I would think, actually, that he'd want to ease into the tournament. Wouldn't want to be playing too well too soon. Want to sort of develop the game as the matches go by and just gradually get just that little bit fitter and get the timing just that little bit more spot on. Would hate to come in playing too well, and there is a great danger of that happening in some instances. Though quite clearly, this is not a problem for Stefan Edberg. At the moment, I know he's been wrestling with his serve for some considerable time. In Paris, it was a bit of a problem for him. He subsequently lost to Medvedev, basically because his serve wasn't more powerful. His problem, I suppose, is not to get paranoid about his serve, not to get obsessed by the fact that he's not serving as well as he would like. And of course, it's that fine line of relaxation and yet intensity that is so difficult to find. However, he has earned himself the right now to close out this second set, if he should hold on to this service game. And if he can just close out this set, I'm sure that will make quite a bit of difference for him. It'll enable him to relax and open his shoulders just a little bit more and play more freely. 5-4.
Forty love.
Tony Pickard watching his man, Stefan Edberg, looking like he's got the second set sewn up. 3 set points.
Game and second set, Edberg, 6-4. Edberg leads by 2-0. Grzetski to serve. Love 15. Thirty all. 40-30.
Oh, that's
game. Rozetsky.
Not a great shot from Edberg.
First game, third set. Edberg leads by 2 sets to 0.
And it was absolutely crucial for Rozetsky to hang on to his service game there.
Yes, it certainly was. And he played positively, but Rozetsky desperately needs to keep this one service game ahead. Now, his chance of survival in this match is to keep holding his serve, just to be that one game in the lead, so that hope to get to 5-4 with Edberg serving under a little bit of pressure and make the break. I think that is
time
he will be hoping. Of course, in the meantime, he'll be working hard to try to get a break earlier than that, but I suspect at 5-4 towards the end of the set is when player of Edberg's stature is just that little bit more vulnerable.
To your seats quickly, please. Seats quickly, thank you.
So the score, love one. Third set, it's Edberg to serve.
Perfect serve and volley tennis.
Rozetsky plays a good point here. The serve short, he's inside the baseline. Now he plays a good half volley forehand cross court. Edberg struggling to gain balance and then is passed beautifully. Just a little bit of let cord, but it was a winner.
Important point that for Rozetsky. Good return there would have made life interesting. Nice idea, trying to ring the changes with the topspin lob, but it's always a difficult shot to control.
Game Edberg. New balls, please. One game on. Third set.
Edberg looking for his third Wimbledon singles title. Not won it since 1990. A surprising record, really, I think, for a man so suited to the grass court game. Seeded 2 this year.
Love.
30.
Well, Edberg was getting as close as he could do there to getting the hang of it. A clever little low chipped return and almost ran down the volley.
Fortilla.
Nothing he could do about Ruzedski's seventh ace.
Game. Ruzedski. Ruzedski leads by 2-1, third set. Edberg leads by 2 sets to love.
Well, a good service game by Ruzedski. But just having a quick look at the statistics and the break points, which of course is the most important points really in a match, we can see that the break points that Edberg has had, six break points Edberg has had, of which he's only had two, whereas Ruzedski, just one break point, and he secured the immediate break. Now, Edberg, under normal circumstances, the feature of his game would be to be making those break points, and that invariably is the difference between the better player and the less good player, and that's an indicator that his game isn't quite en song, not as he would like.